Hello, it's Crafty Rhea, and I am back today with another video. Thank you so much for joining me. This video is a little bit different. I purchased a Goodwill BlueBox of DIY jewelry. I thought I could use it to either sell on eBay if the pieces are good, or to either keep them for myself if I like them, or to use them for crafting. So this is a 5-pound box of jewelry, and the website is Goodwill BlueBox, and it was $29.99 plus $5 shipping. So I'm really excited to dig into this box. All I did was open it. I have not gone through the jewelry yet. So we will see what is in here. If anything strikes your fancy as something that you want to purchase from me, leave me an email or send me an email with the timestamp of about, you know, when it was in the video, you know, at 14 minutes and 27 seconds, I like the blue necklace, and we'll work out a deal. I'll give you a better deal than it would go for on eBay, since I wouldn't have to pay the eBay fees and that sort of thing. So anyway, let's go ahead and get started. I'm really excited to open this box and see what's in here. I think we'll have a lot of good crafting goodies. A lot of the stuff they say is probably broken and suitable for crafting, but we'll see what's in here. It's very exciting. I've seen Melissa and Barbie Girl Thrifter open similar boxes like this from ThredUp, and I'm dying to get my hands on one of those. But I thought this would be so much fun to open this Goodwill box. So I'm going to move the box aside and I will take things out one by one. I don't know really much anything about jewelry. So if you do know about jewelry and can help me out, I would greatly appreciate it. I have no idea what this piece is. It is just a coiled piece of wire. And I don't know if it's supposed to be a ring. If you know what this is, please let me know. I will set that aside. And there's always stuff that's tangled together. There is this bangle bracelet. It's a gold tone. I'm trying to see if there's any markings. I don't see any markings. It does have a little bit of a jingle inside. I'll probably lock some of these things up on eBay as well. And all of the earrings that I find, the single earrings, I will set them aside, and at the end we'll see how many matches we have. Now that's a really cool earring, but I'll set that aside, see if we can find some matches. We have a couple plain bangles there, and this little tiny ring. I don't know if it's like, you know, for a part of your finger there or what it really is for, but I will set that aside. And this shell necklace, it looks like that is the clasp, and the clasp on this side must be broken. But there are a lot of these little green colored beads. Here is another bangle, if I can untangle it. Well, let's see, we got this guy untangled. This is a stretch bracelet. Now, a lot of these can be used for just the beads. These are plastic beads. It's not anything too fancy. It could probably be taken apart and used in crafting. Those beads could be reused. Here is a big earring. I'll put that in my earring pile. Here's another bangle. This one, it has a chip in it. I think it's plastic, but it's very, very heavy. It might be something other than plastic. Make my earring pile there. Here's another one of those little bangles. One of them, as you can see, is really bent up. Put those in a bangle pile. This is a silver colored chain. with this adorable charm. It is a flip-flop. Let me see if there's any markings on this chain. I think it says 925, and if that's the case, then that would be sterling silver. Let me see if there's a marking on the foot. I don't see a marking on that. Let me go get a magnet. Let me untangle the rest of this, and I will take a break and go grab a magnet. All right, I'm going to see if I can get this little guy untangled. This looks like it is all one piece. It is an earring with some feathers. We'll put that in my earring pile. I did get a magnet. And it looks like this chain is magnetic. So it might not be sterling. I'm going to have to look at that a little more closely. But anyway, this is really a cute little necklace. Make my earring pile. This is a bracelet with, it looks like to be wood beads. They're very light. The elastic is not very good in it, but those beads are really unique looking. I'm going to make a pile of the junk bracelets, so to speak, the ones to be used for beads. Then we have this big black necklace. And it has a lot of beads. Some are heavy, but I think they're all plastic. Let me see if there's any markings on it. I don't see any markings. But I think that's kind of a neat, pretty necklace. That could probably go up on eBay. It might be interesting to somebody. That's kind of cool. We have this bangle, which is really a unique looking bangle. I think all the rhinestones are there, and it's like a black enamel on a gold colored metal. Looking to see if there's any markings. I don't see any, but that is really kind of cool. There is this necklace that is broken. These beads are very heavy. I think they are glass beads. It looks like it was a handmade necklace. It would be good for Christmas. The beads on that are really pretty. I grabbed a piece of white cardstock so I can use that. I don't think things are showing up very good on my mat. But there is this really pretty handmade necklace. But I think that would go in the bead pile because the beads could be used for a craft, and they are really pretty red, white, and green glass beads. And another earring for the earring pile. We'll go through the earring pile at the end. We have this ring. I don't think it's glass. It feels cool though. It might be an epoxy ring. It is very pretty. It's very unique. It's probably a size 8, maybe 7.5 or 8, just based on how it fits my finger. There's this other little bracelet. It is not a stretchy bracelet. It has the clasp, and these are beads are heavy. They don't feel like plastic, but I don't think they're real stone. Let me see if I can find a marking. I don't see any markings on it, but like I said, they feel, at least these beads, the gray ones are some sort of a stone. Another one of those red bangles. And then there's this. I have no idea what that is. Whoops, it's broken now. It is a bunch of little beads. I'm going to put this in my bead pile. It was probably some sort of a homemade bracelet. There is this wired piece. I have no idea what that is for. There was also this little piece, which I don't know what that is for either. I don't see any markings on that. Another very bent up black bangle. These beads feel like glass beads to me. On this little bracelet, it is stretchy, but as you can see, most of the stretch has worn out. They are very pretty. They're a bluish green color. I'll put that in the bead pile. Here is a ring. It is definitely plastic. It doesn't feel heavy like this one. This one is a little heavier. This is a very light plastic. It's probably a size 7 would be my guess. I don't have a ring sizer. Here's a wavy bangle. I don't see a marking. Another bracelet that is stretchy. I bet it matches this first one. These two look very similar and would look good together. This is probably 3 of the 5 pounds that were in the box. Let me see if I can get some of this untangled. Another one of those red bangles. And these are just some loose beads on a string. They're very pretty. They feel like wood beads. They're really cool looking. Put that in the bead pile. There's this bracelet. It's a stretchy bracelet. The beads look pretty worn or dirty. They're kind of plasticky, I think. And there's this owl. He's really cool. Let's see if I can get it apart. Yep. There's this owl pendant, and he is missing one stone. I'll look and see if there's a loose stone at the bottom of the box. See if there's any marking on here. I don't see any. These are some, looks just like some silver colored chains. I think they are together. With some strings attached. Let's get that apart. So we have this, which is just 4 different silver colored chains. I don't see any markings as far as a name brand. I'll set that aside. Then there is this, which is, I think it's broken, yeah. So we have, essentially, it's supposed to be 3 beaded chains. It would be very pretty if it was all together, but these beads might be useful. They feel heavy, and they sound like glass, and they feel cold to the touch. So I don't think they're plastic. I think they are glass. I think these are definitely plastic, but the other ones might be glass beads. Let's see if there's a name brand on here. There is this little heart. So if any of you know what name, what brand that would be with that little heart up there, if that's like a signature brand, that would be good. It has the toggle clasp. I don't know if it's fixable. I might be able to fix that and salvage that piece. And we have another earring for the earring pile. And this is just a clasp and an extender. It looks like there's some string, but I could always put that in my jewelry making kit because that might come in handy. There is this bracelet, and it is, feels like faux pearl. And it's on that memory wire that will wrap around your wrist a few times. It's kind of cute. It's not something I would wear, but somebody might like it. I think it's missing a charm or a bead on this end, but that would be easy enough to fix. So there is that. And then there's this necklace. It is missing a little white bead out of there. And it looks like there should be something else along that side. Now, this wouldn't be too bad if to take this piece and like cut a strand of it and use that on a card, or to use some of these pieces, like if you had a hula girl or something, you could use that as her skirt on a card, something like that. So that could definitely be a crafting piece. We have another bangle here. It says BCB Generation, Share the Love. I don't know what BCB Generation is. Powerful, creative, and strong. It does have some wear. The gold is not, the gold is kind of wearing off. But those might be good charms to put on a card. I'm sorry about the lighting. And that one has black rhinestones on it, and that is, they're all intact, so that is good. So that could be in the crafting lot as well, or the crafting pile. Here we have a Christmas tree. It looks like it was maybe crocheted. The back has glitter on it. That would be cute on a card for sure. I'll set that aside. And even with little beads and stuff hanging off of it, might be great. I'm putting all the earring pieces to the side. I see some that I actually like. Another one of those red bangles. There is this piece. I don't know if that says something or means something. And there's this cord. And there is that piece. I'm not sure if it's a saint. If you know what this is, please let me know. I don't really know what it is. You know, some sort of a religious piece. All right, I will set that aside. This is a bracelet. It has a magnet, and there's a lot of things stuck to it. Let me get all of these earrings off of it. It's very glittery. It's very pretty. It has a tassel and a wing. It does look like it is coming apart a little bit here, and this chain is coming apart, but I think a little jewelry glue would be able to fix that right up. It has a couple of jump rings on it that you could put charms on. You take off all those little earrings. And it has a magnetic closure. That's kind of a neat little piece. See if there's any markings, any brand name. That's kind of neat. That could also be used on a card or something like that. You have this tangled necklace. It's a gold tone with some rhinestones. It's very, very pretty. See if there's any kind of a tag or a marking. So pretty. It has all of these little rhinestones. And there's one rhinestone that's kind of a triangle shape, and then one that's flat, a cone shape, I should say. Let's see if I can put it down on this white so you can get a good picture, a good idea. Super duper pretty. There we go. There is one shape of it, and then the other ones are flat. Very shiny. It looks like it doesn't really have any wear. It looks, you know, new as far as the gold color is concerned. Very, very pretty. And it is doubled. It is about 18 inches long, so it's pretty long. So that would be 18 times 2. So that's a really long chain. Very pretty. That is something that I would probably wear. This is funny. This is a bangle. It's really unique looking. It's huge. I'm not going to try to put it on my hand because I would never get it off. It has a couple of dinged up spots around the edges. It would be really cool if you could put something as a bottom and use it as like a little cup to hold paper clips or something like that on your desk. That is really cool. It's very unique looking. Sounds like it might be wood, maybe plastic. It's a very unique little piece. Here is a Hawaii bracelet. I'm sure it was just one of those little tourist shop bracelets, nothing super fancy. This is curved, that says Hawaii. We have an earring. I'm assuming it's Texas, a handmade earring, it looks like. Here's another bangle, and this is very, very pretty. It's I think that's called Mother of Pearl. Super pretty. And this is just a little tiny, I guess, bracelet. And it is marked something. Stella and Dot. I don't know if that's a baby's bracelet or what that is. And here is another just plain little gold colored chain. Some loose beads running around. And this is a stretchy bracelet, kind of feels like seeds almost, seed pods, plasticky beads, kind of doesn't have a whole lot of stretch left, but there is that, unique beads. We have a stretchy ring. It looks like all of the stones are in it. It's a dark antiqued metal. And that's what it looks like. It's kind of a neat little ring. This is really cute. This is an earring, and it's a little fish in a bag. I'll put that in the earring pile. And here we have another one of those Christmas trees. This is really cool, except he's missing a leg. This is a bee or a fly. It's very cool, and it's on an adjustable ring. It looks like the base would be adjustable. Let me see if there's any marking. It looks like there's some script letters in there. I'm not sure if you'd be able to see it, but I can't tell what the marking is. And he is missing a leg, but he is so cute. He could probably cut the other leg off and he wouldn't look bad. And this looks like a piece of stone with some gold leafing around it. These beads are definitely glass. They're cold, they're heavy. It has a pretty good amount of stretch left on this bracelet. Let me zoom you back out. It's kind of neat. We have this little pin. And I don't know what it says. It's H-A-R-U-G-A or L-I-G-A, and it has an H. And then another word that I cannot read. I don't know what that means. I'll have to look it up. If you know what it means or what it is, please let me know. I have this little bracelet with a heart. I'm assuming it's a bracelet, and I'm assuming it comes apart. I'm just not sure how, because there's a joint there that would go on your wrist, and it is marked. It's Kate Spade, New York, is what it says in there, and that's a gold color. So that would probably sell on eBay since it's a name brand. We have this little bracelet with the little evil eyes, or I think the eyes are to prevent evil. Let me zoom in on these two little pieces here so you could see them better. This is very pretty. It has rhinestones in between each of the eyes, and they're heart-shaped, the eyes. I don't see a marking, but that is a really, really cute bracelet, and it measures about 6.5 inches. It's very cute. I like that little bracelet. And I don't know about that pin. I'll have to look it up and see if it means anything. All right, we have some more goodies here and some more loose beads. We have this brooch, which would be beautiful, except the middle piece is missing. So pretty. I wonder if I could find something to go in the middle of that, because it would be a shame to waste that. It is so sparkly. It looks new otherwise, like the metal is not tarnished at all. Here's another one of those rings. This one feels like stone, and I believe it has been broken in the past because it looks like it's glued together. It's about a size 7. Here is a little Hello Kitty ring. So cute. It's, of course, little for a little girl. I love it. That's so cute. Then we have this necklace. It's on a stretchy cord. I think this would go in the bead pile because I think the beads would be usable. I'm not sure if it would be something someone would want to wear. The pearls are hooked together with like little jump rings. There is this necklace and it just says Y-A-S-S-S-S-S, yes. And it has broken, it has come apart. I wonder if this is the other side. I could probably put this back together. I don't know if it would be sellable on eBay or not, but that is really cute. And there's some bonus free hair in there. I forgot what the term is that people use when they find the hair. This looks like a choker. It is a gold colored metal. It looks pretty antiqued. It has this toggle closure. I wonder if it would clean up well and look a little bit prettier and shinier. But the clasps are really, really cool. I went and got a little cup here that I could put some of these loose beads in so they're not going all over the place, because I think as I get down to the bottom of the box, there'll be a lot more loose beads. Here we have a charm bracelet. It has these like pearly type beads, maybe, I don't know, they almost look like a mother of pearl, but I don't think they're the right color. Has a little odd shaped pearly looking bead, and it has a toggle closure. It's kind of cool. I don't see any markings, and boy, my hands are dirty. This one's really cool. Let me see how long it is. About 8 inches. And that's it with the toggle clasp. Kind of a really neat charm bracelet. I like that. Let's get these beads wrangled up. Put all my little earrings over there. We have a zipper pull. This looks like it went to an earring. It is a star with a couple little shooting stars off of it. That would be really cute on a card. There is this bracelet. These are glass beads. They're all different. They're on a stretchy band, which probably needs some more stretch put back to it, but it's kind of cool. I'll put that in the bead pile. We have this bracelet. It's so pretty. These are glass faceted beads, and they are so sparkly. Cookie Lee, I don't know, and it says China on the back, but I'll have to look it up. It is so, so pretty. We have this tangled up necklace. I'm not going to try to untangle it. And it just has this round piece. Nothing special. It would be in the junk jewelry pile for sure, because that's kind of bent up. There is this piece that belongs to something. I have no idea what it is. It's a huge, heavy ring. Very heavy. It's well worn, maybe a size 8. It's got a black, I think it's a plastic bead on there, but the metal is super duper heavy on that ring. Oh, these zipper pulls are earrings. It has, this one has the little earring back, and that one would need an earring back replaced there. That's so cute. There is this little piece that looks like a crown. It was probably part of a bigger piece of jewelry. There's this bracelet that has several missing rhinestones. Otherwise, it looks like it was very pretty, but it is worn and has a bunch of missing rhinestones that would be for crafting. And this little tiny bracelet with a leaf, with just these little copper-colored stones. Some of these earrings are so pretty. I hope I can find the matches. This is a brooch. I don't see any markings. It's just a rose. Whoops. A rose. Some of these earrings are so pretty. I hope I have matches. This is a tiny ring. I mean, I guess it would fit on a pinky, my pinky, so I don't know what size it is. It looks like a keyhole. It's very unique looking. That's a gorgeous little earring. I hope the second one is in here. Some earring backs. It's just a little shamrock. And a heart pin that says MTS. I don't know what that stands for. This looks like a baby ring. It is, I think, wood. And it has the little beads. And it does say something on the back. It's HABA. I don't know what that means. And this looks like it came off of a necklace. It might be a pendant because there's a hole on each side and it has like a blue, I think you call that a moonstone. And here is another pin. And I don't know who that is on there. If you know, please let me know. This is a little bag of big clear plastic beads. They're kind of pretty, very faceted. We're getting down to the end here. A lot of loose beads. We have this ring on a stretchy back. It's green and blue. It's kind of pretty. The stretchy backs are neat because they fit just about any finger. Very, very large ring. Very cool. This is a bracelet and it has a puffy heart hanging off of it, so I don't know if that's indicative of a name brand. It has just some silver colored beads along a silver colored string. It's very pretty. Then there is this. I'm not sure if this goes over a shoe. It's got this clasp and it has little spikes on the back of it. It is missing the bead in the center. I'm not sure if that would go on a purse or a shoe, but again, if you had that bead, it's very pretty. Whoa. All right, let me put some of these beads in my little bead bowl. This is a little pin. It looks very old. It has a couple of missing stones. It looks very worn. I don't know if it's just looking worn because of the age. It's like the gold color on it's very pitted. Sorry about the light in here. Maybe if I bring it down, you could see how pitted and worn that is, but it's very pretty, or at least it was very pretty in some at some point. This looks like just a little ring, handmade. This is an adorable earring. It's a little lizard. I'll put it in my earring pile and see if I can find the other one. This is a little ring. It's adjustable. It's a child's ring, and it says Her Royal Highness. This is adorable. It is a bird. And it's a pin back. So that is really, really pretty. It looks like it might have one little rhinestone missing, but it's really hard to tell. So that is so, so pretty. It's just a couple links to a watch band or a bracelet. This is just a little a little choker, and it does have a marking on it. Forolav, F-O-R-O-L-A-V. I don't know. Let's see what else I have in here. This is a little panda bear. Another one of those little, might be an old earring. It's got a screw on back. No, it's not an earring. It's a pin because it's definitely super sharp, like a cufflink or something. More of those little watch type links. A couple little charms here. We have a star and a heart. This is a broken pendant, but it could be used on something for crafting. This is a bracelet, gold colored bracelet with all these little spiky pieces hanging off. Trying to see if there's any markings. I don't see any. It has a couple little balls with rhinestones on it. It's kind of cute. Very heavy. Oh, goody. The other fish, and it doesn't have an earring hook, but those would make such a cute little pair of earrings. That's easy enough to fix. I would probably put two earring hooks that match on them. They're so cute. I love those little earrings. This is just a little plastic ring, nothing fancy. US Open 2012, the Olympic Club. I'm not sure what that is, just a coiled piece of a wire. This is a, it looks like a man's bracelet. It says original grain on it, and it's one of these little adjustable bracelets where you could pull it apart. And it has these are definitely stone. I'm not sure if you would put essential oils on that or not. A lot of loose beads. This looks like an 80s piece. It is an enamel pin. There's no markings on it. Kind of neat. A mini shell. Here's a spade. Here's another pin. It has rhinestones. I don't think any are missing, though. It looks like it can hang on a necklace, and it looks like the one piece is bent a little bit. I'm not sure. Yeah, I could bend it right back. It bends pretty easy. So it could hang on a necklace or be a pin. Here's another ring. It's probably wood or plastic. It's pretty small. It fits my pinky. I don't know what size my pinky is. It's kind of neat. This is really cool. We have this pink bird with a long beak and rhinestones. I think it has all of the rhinestones in it. I don't see a mark, like a name brand mark. Very pretty though. I'm sure someone would like that. This is a little hair clip. It's a heart that could be taken off the hair clip and used on a Valentine card. Now I think most of what's left in here are going to be just beads and maybe some earrings. I'll try to pull the earrings out and set them aside, and then we'll match them up. And I'll put the beads in this little bead bowl. There's some little shells. I am going to organize the beads and bag them up, pair up the earrings, and then I will be back and I will show you all of the goodies. Okay, bye for right now. Okay, I sorted the earrings, and this is what I have as far as pairs of earrings. Some of them need a little bit of work. But I have this pair with these gold coins on them. Let me see if I can get my camera better. So we have this pair with these green beads and the gold coins. This one just needs an earring hook, a fish hook, but I think all of the parts of those are there. Have these little mini hoops. Have these bigger silver color hoops. This pair, I think these are wine bottle markers, because they're not, I don't think they're earrings, not wine bottle, but wine glass charms. We have one in green and one in pink. And then there's also this one with the grapes. So we have those three. They're not earrings, but they are good for wine glass charms. We have these two little rope knots. They're in a gold tone metal. We have a lot of these little studs. This is a stud with a little ball hanging off in kind of a brushed gold color. We have these tiny little ones in a gold color. These silver color ones that are like a brushed silver. We have copper ones. These little copper looking balls, or rose gold probably actually. They look more like a rose gold color. I don't know if any of these are real gold. This is a pair that looks like a little cubic zirconia or glass. I'm not sure. These are really pretty, and these are a pink stone stud. Very pretty, very sparkly in real life. These look like just some flat gunmetal earrings. another pair of those brushed ones, but those look like rose gold. These are really cute. I don't know what character this is. If you guys know, let me know. It's very cute. There is this pair, although one is missing the piece on the back, but that could be glued on real easy. This is not a pair, but they both match. It's a red and black. These are really pretty. They are a sparkly, looks like crushed diamonds, but I don't think they're real. Very pretty though. These two pearl drop earrings, faux pearl. And these are also very pretty. These are these little blue stones. We have the zippers, the little zipper pull earrings. One of them does need a back put on it. We have these two little hearts. They are a very tarnished looking gold color. We have these circles in a silver color. I love these. I'm so glad there was the pair. These are rhinestones and faux pearls. Very pretty, but they would look good for a wedding or something like that. So pretty. Then we have these two in this kind of a brushed yellow gold with some black. These two little squares in a silver color. These two clip-on earrings in the silver kind of a square. Another pair of clip-ons. Very big, chunky silver. And I showed you these little fish bags before. These are so cute. I love them. Very cute. Those would probably sell. This is a pin. It's for a golfer. And the panda pin. This little alligator or crocodile. Do you know the difference between an alligator and a crocodile? I'll give you a minute. One will see you later, and the other one will see you in a while. Okay, and then we have a lot of earrings that are single, and I'm not going to show you each and every one, but I'll show you some of my favorites. We have this. I really wish there were two of these, but there's just one, and I can use it as an embellishment, maybe on my pocket letter that I'm going to make. We also have one of these, which is really pretty. That would make a really pretty embellishment. And this big hoop, that might look pretty on something. We have some feathers that could go on a card, and there's this other feather that could be used in crafting as well. Now, probably my favorite single earring would be, I'll show you that one last. There's this one that's an origami fish, which could be used on a craft item as well. This is pretty and would go good on a craft. I wish I had both of those. A bunch of really little tiny ones, like this really tiny flamingo. I wish I had both of. Oh, I do have some little ones. I bagged them up in here. They're little mini frogs, little mini music notes, and little mini flowers. There's three pair there, and they are, you know, actual pairs. So then my favorite one, I wish I had both, but there is this. I will set it down. Now that would go great on a card though. I think that is so pretty. It is metal and it has some enamel on it. And I don't think there's a mark on it, but that is gorgeous. That I'll be able to use. It looks like a stained glass window. Then I also have, let's see, we have the Texas one. It just looks like someone just painted that on a piece of paper, but that could be used on a craft item as well. And then we have these two little buckets of assorted beads. I will sort them out. We have a lot of faux pearls. We have a lot of shaped faux pearls, like dented pearls. I have quite a few earring backs and pieces that I will separate out, and I'll put those in baggies to have. I also have this little baggie of clasps for necklaces, this little baggie of different hearts, spades, diamonds, and clubs that could be used on a card or on a charm bracelet for someone maybe that likes to play poker, things like that. There's quite a few neat little doodads. Like there's this one that would go good as an embellishment on a card or something like that. So a lot of this stuff will be put to good use. It'll be in a crafting lot. Oh, here's another one of my favorites that I wish I had both for. It's this bow. But that would look good if I just cut the shank off and put that on a card or a Christmas ornament or something like that. That would be really pretty. Alrighty, well, thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate each and every one of you. If you like what you see, please click that subscribe button. You might see more of these goodies coming up in future projects. I will also be listing some of this on my eBay store, and that link is below. If you are interested in purchasing anything that I have unboxed today, just leave me an email. Send me an email at tigoria@gmail.com with the timestamp of whatever you're interested in, and we'll work out a deal. I'd love it if you headed on over to my Facebook group, Create with Crafty Rhea. We do a whole bunch of fun stuff over there as well. And I wish to thank you again for watching. I do appreciate you. And until the next video, you know what to do. Go get crafting. Bye-bye.